My name is Eric Jacobsen. I'm the clinical director of the adult lymphoma program at Dana-Farber, and I'm also the director of the Adult Histiocyte Disorders Center, also at Dana-Farber. And today I wanted to discuss a recent report that we had in a very rare histiocyte disorder called Rosia-Dorfman disease. Rosia-Dorfman disease is a benign growth of histiocytes, which are a type of immune cell. Classically, Rosia-Dorfman disease affects children and presents as very enlarged lymph nodes in the neck that quite often spontaneously go away on their own. And for a long time, it has been thought that maybe this was triggered by a viral infection or other type of infection, although despite numerous studies, no infectious agent has been discovered, and as of now, the cause of the disease remains unknown. In other settings, Rosia-Dorfman disease can affect other areas of the body, so we do see it in lymph nodes outside of the neck. We sometimes see it in the skin, in the nervous system, or the bone, and occasionally even see it in organs such as the kidney and the liver. Thankfully, most of the time it's a very slow-growing process, and in fact, in up to 50% of the cases, will resolve on its own without any treatment. In some settings, patients do need prednisone or other steroids to help shrink the disease. And very rarely, patients even require chemotherapy to treat the disease. It's a very small subset of patients that ever need chemotherapy, but for that small subset, unfortunately, the disease can sometimes be quite aggressive and rarely can even be fatal. Our report recently in the New England Journal of Medicine built upon some discoveries by colleagues at Memorial Sloan Kettering Cancer Center in New York. And those investigators identified a series of mutations that seem to be important in driving the growth of Rosia-Dorfman disease. And we had a patient in whom we identified one of these mutations in a gene called RAS, R-A-S. And fortunately, there's now a medication, or actually several medications, that can target that mutation. So in this particular instance, we treated this patient with a drug known as cobimetinib, which can block the RAS mutation. And that patient had a dramatic response to cobimetinib treatment. He had a very large mass prior to starting the treatment, and that mass shrank rapidly and shrank dramatically while he was on the drug. Similar findings have actually been reported in New York, so we were encouraged by this accumulating evidence that not only was identifying these mutations important in figuring out what causes the disease, but we could now capitalize on that discovery and bring new treatments into the clinic. At the moment, it's really a small number of patients for whom this would ever be relevant or necessary, but I think in that small percentage of patients, this could be a very important treatment. And currently, there are studies ongoing in a larger group of patients with Rosia-Dorfman disease and other histiocyte disorders to confirm these findings and to confirm that cobimetinib is an effective therapy in this group of patients. So I'm optimistic that this is the start of a new treatment breakthrough in this rare disease. It goes to show that with persistence and diligence and interest of patients and investigators, that we can actually identify relevant mutations in rare diseases and then act on those mutations and bring new therapies to the clinic.